What's up, everybody? Keith Mitchell from the Outerhaven here. While many of you are finally getting a chance to dig into Rockfish Games Everspace 2, I've had the pleasure of playing it these past few days. And a big thank you to Rockfish Games for providing the early access ahead of the official release, which is January 18th, 2021, which is probably past by the time you hear this video. Now, I've always been a fan of space combat sim games, and playing Everspace 2 was like taking a trip to the past. I'm talking about games that I grew up with, such as Wing Commander, Privateer, Star Lancer, and the Freelancer games. Now, those were some great times. And for a while, I had wondered if we ever see games like that ever again. Sure, I know there are several space combat games out there, such as Elite Dangerous. However, that game is more of a combat meets a trading game. And while it sounds interesting, I wanted something that was a bit more simplistic, something that was easier for me to get involved with, which is where Everspace 2 comes in. On the surface, it looks like the first Everspace games, but there's where the comparison stops. Well, other than it's in space. Everspace 2, for lack of a better word, is a completely different game altogether. Now, while I don't want to spoil the game, as I feel everybody who's interested or who is curious about the game will want to find out about the game themselves, and I can respect that. However, I did want to do a short video and toss some praise towards the developer for what they've done with this game. Honestly, I've played this game nonstop for the past 5 days, and I've reached the end of it. The end of the early access story mode, that is, not the game itself, because the full game hasn't been completed as of yet. The scope of this game is simply amazing, and again, it's a huge departure from the original game. While Everspace 1 was a space combat game with role-like elements and some story sprinkled in, the follow-up is much more story-based and is apparent the first time you start the game. It really smacks you in the face of how different this game is compared to the first game. A full-fledged story this time that starts out fast, and during my time with the early access game, it did not let up. Even though I'm sad that after playing this game for about 13 hours or so, and the story abruptly ends, to be fair, they did mention the story mode was only about 12 hours in the early access game, so I can't really complain about that. And as I mentioned, I don't want to spoil the game. However, for those who did play the first Everspace game, there is a lot of throwbacks to the original game, and the plot actually is interconnected. That's all I'm going to say. Again, if you played the first game, there's going to be a big smile on your face when you come up to a certain part in Everspace 2. I'm not going to tell you what it is. I'm not going to ruin the game. And speaking of the story, every bit of it was completely voiced. I mean, everything. When I first talked to developers, they were like, yeah, this game is going to be voiced. I thought it was going to be certain segments of the game. No, the entire story has been voiced. Every part. And I'm not just talking about the story. If you stop at a space station or if you talk to a random NPC that you encounter during your time with the game, everything is voiced. And the voiceovers are amazing. I enjoyed them a lot more than I expected I would. The combat has been fine-tuned as well, and it's much more enjoyable this time around. While the original game had me losing interest at times, I really did not enjoy the first game. While with Everspace 2, I didn't mind being blown up or going back after the outlaw who did blow me up or jumping into a random mission or countering something completely new. In fact, I found myself just loading up the game just to cruise around through the cosmos and find some baddies to blow them up and earn some extra experience and some extra money as well. As far as I'm aware, progression will persist up until the game gets released, I think sometime in the end of 2021 or early 2022. I don't know. The developer hasn't really mentioned anything. So I do think that maybe I should reach out to Rockfish Games and find out what their plans are, because I hate to do all this progression and have all these ships and they come out and go, oh, hey, by the way, we're going to wipe out your progression. Whether that happens or not remains to be seen. But let's get back to the game. Now, talking about the cosmos, even though there's only two playable areas in the current build right now, those areas are big, and I mean super big. To give you an idea on just how big they are, you could travel around the area for a good half an hour or so, just for regular propulsion, and still not come across everything. Or you could jump into jump space, where you might encounter a random distress signal, or an unknown signal, or a completely different location that you never saw before, and maybe swore to yourself, hey, I thought I saw everything in this sector, and unknowing to yourself, hey, this is something brand new that just popped up out of nowhere. Little surprises like that that has me so invested in this game and why I simply cannot wait for the full version to come out. And it's not just the sectors or the area that you play in. There's just so much customization. For example, your ship. You can change the color of your ship, so you can basically have one ship that looks like Iron Man, another ship that looks like War Machine, which are some of my favorite characters in the Marvel Cinematic Universe. both the comics as well. Or you can add different types of weapons. You can have Gauss weapons, you can have laser weapons, you could have auto cannons, you could have mines, you could have missiles, shooting out missiles like you're playing a Macross game with hundreds of missiles going everywhere at once. It's simply glorious. I freaking love that. That right there is the stuff of Legends. I need to put the fanboy away for a minute and just be honest with you. This is a great game for those who like space combat and who love tons of exploration and find new things. There's just so many things that are tucked in this game that you simply have to experience it for yourself. I can't begin to tell you how many times I geeked out when I came across an abandoned space station or a massive space cruiser that you can fly inside, solving puzzles and random things that you encounter as you're inside the ship, or just cruising around the cosmos, blasting baddies or having baddies blast you, or just taking in the sights. It's an amazing game, and so far, I can't say enough about this game. Easily one of my favorite games of 2021. And this year had just kicked off. And obviously, Rockfish Games had a long road ahead of them. They're nowhere near finished. They put out a patch note a couple days ago saying these are all the things they plan on doing to the game. And just so much stuff they have planned. I simply cannot wait for the finished version. But for now, if you were to ask me, hey, Keith, is this game worth it? If you enjoy space combat games and you love exploration, I highly recommend you pick it up. Right now, the game is again early access on Steam. It is $39.99. And even though early access games sometimes get a bad rub, this game is very polished. They've already dropped one patch for the game that corrected some of the issues that I had already with the game. Again, I simply cannot say enough about this game. I'm geeking out, I'm fanboying, I'm really enjoying my time. And again, even though the story mode is over, I'm still playing this game. Once again, everybody, this game is Everspace 2 from Rockfish Games on Steam for the PC. No idea if it's coming to console yet, but seeing how the first game made its way to the consoles, I have no doubt that Everspace 2 will also make it over there one day. After the PC version is done, that is. As always, if you enjoyed the video, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Thanks for watching.